As we bow before you, we ask, God, that thou would have mercy upon us. Forgive us, Lord, of our sins, and help us in the name of Jesus to be victorious in everything that we say and do, that it will be pleasing in your name. We ask, God, that you will remember the prayer requests that have called in, and those who in the sanctuary have asked that we pray for those, their loved ones, that you would touch in the name of Jesus. God, send your healing virtue. Lord, remember those, God, who are in convalescence among us. God, remember those in bereavement. We continue to pray for the Dunlap family. We're praying, God, that you would touch the Dempse family in a special way. And all the other members of God who are in bereavement, that you would touch in the name of Jesus. Remember, God, those who are seeking you for salvation. Bless them, God. Continue, Lord, to encourage their hearts the more. We come against the enemy that comes to steal, to kill, and destroy. Lord, send your victory in the name of Jesus, and we'll give you the praise, we'll give you the glory, we'll lift you up, God, because you are worthy. We thank you for everything that you've done, God. We have a spirit of expectation. We know that you're going to do it because you've done it again. God, bless those who are listening to us. Whatever the need may be, God, we ask that you would stretch forth your mighty hand and send deliverance, God. Send salvation. Remember the city. Remember, Lord, the Camp Life Oak community, that you would touch, God. Draw. You said, if you be lifted up, we pray in you today, God, for victory in the name of Jesus. Receive our prayer and grant us our peace, and we shall forever give you the glory. This is our prayer in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord, everyone. Praise the Lord, everyone. We'd like to welcome you today to the Great Refuge Church, located in Deland, Florida, at 316 South Adele Avenue, where our pastor is Bishop James Darby. We would like for you to be able to participate in the ministry of giving. If you would like to do so by way of Cash App, our Cash App tag is $DELANDREFUGE. Again, the Cash App tag is $DELANDREFUGE. Or if you would like to do so by way of PayPal, the email address for PayPal is DELANDREFUGE386@gmail.com. Again, the email address for PayPal is DELANDREFUGE386@gmail.com. Or if you would like to mail in your gifts, you may do so by using our mailing address, which is 316 South Adele Avenue, Deland, Florida, and our zip code is 32720. Again, the mailing address is 316 South Adele Avenue, Deland, Florida, and our zip code is 32720. We would like for you to know that we are a 501c3 ministry. This information will be pinned into our live stream. Thank you.
Praise the Lord, everyone. Praise the Lord, everyone. Come on, let's give God praise here in the building. Let's just give God some praise. Wherever you are, let's give the Lord some praise, because the Lord is worthy of the praise. Hallelujah. I don't know about you, I come to give God some praise. Zion is calling us to a higher place of praise. And we want to be positioned ourselves in order for the Lord to bless us. Oh, yes, Lord. Thank you.
be a blessing of God to share the gospel of Jesus Christ with you. And to those of you that are here scattered throughout the assembly this morning from the church, I want you to turn your Bibles to the 12th chapter, verse 16 through 21. St. Luke chapter 12, verse 16 through verse 21. Jesus is the speaker, and the Bible declared that he spoke a parable unto them, saying, the ground of a rich man brought forth plentifully. And he thought within himself, saying, what shall I do? Because I have no room where to restore my fruits. And he said, here's what I do. I will pull down my barns and build greater. And there will I restore all my fruits and my goods. And I will say to my soul, soul, thou hast much goods laid up for many years. Take thine ease, eat, drink, and be merry. And I will say to my soul, thou hast much good laid up for many years. Take thine ease, eat, drink, and be merry. But God said unto him, thou fool, this night shall be thy soul with it is required. And tell me who shall do you those things be which thou hast provided. And so it is he that laid up treasures for himself and is not rich toward God. A simple subject of a simple text. Talk about life's consistency. What is your life? What is your life? One writer in the book of James declared that life is as a vapor. It's just like a mist. Is here one moment and it's gone the next moment. Yes. This silly fable expression, cat has nine lives. And some folk act like they fit into that fable. Not even gonna live forever. God has been so gracious to so many of us. We've looked death in the face. Yes. And only the grace of God spared our lives on many occasions. When we look back over dangerous situations that we were involved in, we can only say, if it had not been for God. Many times We've had sicknesses that took some folk out, but we are still here. Only by the grace of God.
Thank you, Lord.
The text says today, young man had come to Jesus earlier on and said to the Lord, speak to my brother that he might divide the inheritance with me. Evidently, I assume that older brother is just an innocent, was the rightful heir to the inheritance. And the other one was not in the will. But he asked Jesus, speak to my brother that he might divide the inheritance with me. Jesus' response was him was this: man, who made me a judge or divider over you? Then he said to them, beware of covetousness, for man's life consists not in abundance of the things that he possesses. In times as these, for the most part in many minds, not just those outside of the church, but inside the church, minds are wrapped up in materialistic things. Many preachers preach, and the whole sermon is surrounded by money. Most of the jets they ride in, fine, you got a jet, I don't need one. Fine cars, all kinds of money things. And all of it is instilled in the minds of those that are listening to them. Even when it comes to the house of God, Lord's lady guy looked and saw the temple of God in ruin. And he said, you dwelled in your sealed houses in my house laid in ruins. Some of us live in mansions, change suits each week. Hello. Got money laid up in the bank, and the house of God go ruined. We get caught up in stuff. And that seems to be the thing of the day. And when God brings some of us out, we propose a junk group, young dog. God put clothes on our backs, money in your pockets, fine house to live in, and then you value your house, your car, your money above God. This man said, looking in the future, he had prepared for his future. Looked at it. I don't have enough money. All that I have, I don't have enough room to put So he had his answer to his problem. But your answer to your problem is not the real answer. He said, I know what I'll do. I will tear down. Oh, I'll build bigger ones. And then I'm going to restore my fruit, all my goods, equivalent to all my money, all my stocks, all my investment. Leave no 401k, you'll call it. And I'm just going to enjoy myself. Because I'm set for life. It's good to be set. But don't forget the man that set you up. She said, I have the answer. Thinking only about himself. The sin says no man is an island. I'm gonna take it easy now. I'm gonna take it easy now. I'm gonna say to my soul, relax. Enjoy your life for the rest of your life. Some years ago, as I said, as the international evangelist for the churches of our Lord Jesus Christ, I developed the Constitution I ratified that every preacher that was not a pastor or had an assignment as assistant pastor would automatically be a part of the board of evangelists. Of course, it was never ratified. Preacher would come to me and say to me, Elder Darby, at that time it was Elder Darby, when I retire, I want to join the board out of the evangelists. I've never seen it work out. When I retire, well, you got God on the back burner now. If you can't be faithful before you retire, forget about it when you retire. I'll have a prayer meeting. I'll do this. It never works. If you don't praise God first now, what are you going to do in the years to come? The Bible said, be thou faithful unto death. From the beginning of your race or your relationship with God, that's when it begins. And it ends in this. This man had made a decision relevant to his life, but God looked at him and said, you fool! The death angel is going to visit your house. It's coming to your house this night. If I call you a fool, you don't necessarily have to be a fool. But if God calls you a fool, fool you a fool. God, this night, not tomorrow night, this night, your soul is required of you. And you don't have but one soul, baby. And if you lose that soul, that's it. That's it. That's it. That's it. That's it. No coming back, no return. Decision has to be yours. to determine what your life is, how valuable your life is. It has a destination of misery unless God is in that life. God, stop. You don't know. Some of us think we're so smart. Nobody can tell us nothing. We got all the answers. But the time is coming where you're going to say, I wish I had listened. If this man could have done it all over again, he said, I'd have kept the barns I got. I put food in the mouth of the hungry, clothing on the back of the litigant. I wouldn't live like I was living on an island. But God said, this night, there's no return. This night, not tomorrow night, but this night. What is your life? James says, it's like a vapor. It's here one moment. Yes. One moment, and the next moment, it's gone. It's gone. Time is running out for all of us. For all of us. The time will come when we get to that point where the silver lining began to be broken. The fountain is drying up. And look at ourselves. And we can just see that it's just a matter of time. Some of you listening to me right now, it is only a matter of time. Your years will soon turn into months. It's just a matter of time. Your months will be reduced to weeks. Your weeks are turning into days. Your days are turning into hours. Your hours into minutes. Your minutes into the second. And that's it. That's it. That's it. That's it. What are you going to do about time while you got time? What are you going to do about your life while you have the breath in your body? What are you going to do? Soon that breath will leave you and your spirit will come to the God that gave it. Every human being, when they leave here, their spirit goes to God. What do you say to the unsaved? Your soul either to paradise, to rest until the Lord get ready to rapture your body. What about those that are lost? The souls go into the pits of hell. Torment. 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 Unquenchable fire. Oh! It's just an imagination. There's a fire. That's in the heart of the earth. Geological science verifies the fact that the intensified heat in the earth, it changes the earth's surface. Or the things right below earth's surface. Over many years, because of this fire. It's down in the heart of the earth that is cold hell. That's not a myth. Verified by the pages of geological science. I don't want to go there. I'm not planning and I ain't going there. I said, I ain't going there. I choose not to have my life built on things of the earth. I've had access to many things. Still have access to other things. But I would not allow. I'm listening. I'm saying to my brothers and my sisters, a job, money, a house, even a relationship. Let's not support it by God. Loved ones. What would it profit if I were to gain the whole world and lose my soul? I think about this boy, now 50 years old now, sitting before me. There were those that offered millions of dollars to get involved in that secular world. I think it was $1 million one time. Secular world. But they wanted to do it under the table. If only he'd made the mistake to become an instant millionaire, I doubt he'd be sitting here now. You can't allow. You can't allow. To destroy your life. You can't allow it. You see another side. You see the other side. You see the other side. That will have an invention in your name there. But you have to come to the place when he says, let's make a deal. Come on now. You tell him, I don't deal. And I'm not coming anywhere. Because I know him who died for me. You have to make choices. And you have to live with the choices that you make. Just one bad choice can ruin your life for the rest of your life. Just one bad choice. You can make a decision, and that decision is irreversible. You can't change it. Wherever you are, around the globe, across the United States of America, within the proximity of this church, wherever you are, ask yourself, what is my life? What is my life? It's not built, it's not made up of the things that I possess. You came here naked. You may be dressed up going out. But you can't take nothing with you. A woman I heard say this morning here, man was so stingy, had his wife, and he said, when I die, I want to put all my money in my casket. I'm leaving nothing behind. She wrote a check out, put the check in the casket. He went on probably to hell with his check. What is your life? life is saying to this fellow here in this text, oh God, Lord, call me a fool. If I walked up to some of y'all and called y'all a fool, you wouldn't be back to church the next evening. And some of you wouldn't come back no more. He said, that preacher you talk about me all over town, and add some old stuff to it. But if God called you a fool, there ain't a thing that you pick enough to do anything about. I wouldn't want God to call me a fool. No, 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 no. I don't know if he felt he could do it all over again. He changed his mind. And I'm saying today, this isn't about, don't allow things